भावना
गुड
मैम,
इवनिंग
गुड इवनिंग
मैम,
दिव्या मैम, गुड इवनिंग गौतम सर मैम, वर्तिनी मैम, गुड
गुड इवनिंग मैम।
इवनिंग, गुड इवनिंग। ओके सो वी कैन स्टार्ट राइट?
यस मैम।
ओके सो एनी डाउट फ्रॉम यस्टरडे सेशन, एनीथिंग?
नो मैम।
ऑल क्लियर?
यस मैम। यस
ओके सो वी डिस्कस्ड व्हाट इज कंपेंसेशन राइट? वी स्टार्टेड दिस। एम आई ऑडिबल?
मैम।
या सो वी डिस्कस्ड व्हाट इज कंपेंसेशन राइट? सर कैन
यस
एनीवन
मैम।
टेल मी व्हाट इज कंपेंसेशन?
Just given by the company to the employee if any difficulties like that, ma'am.
ओके ओके गुड
मैम
ट्राई।
कंपनसेशन मैनेजमेंट मीन्स बैलेंसिंग द वर्क एम्प्लॉय रिलेशन बाय प्रोवाइडिंग मॉनेटरी एंड नॉन मॉनेटरी बेनिफिट्स लाइक पेमेंट्स, ओवर टाइम पे, प्रॉफिट शेयरिंग, कंपनसेशन एंड बोनस एंड रिवॉर्ड ऑल्सो।
करेक्ट करेक्ट भावना मैम। ओके सो यस बेसिकली व्हेन यू आर वर्किंग राइट, you are giving some work to your organization, in return you are getting salary or wages right?
यस मैम।
So that yes, so that and along with that many company provides many non monetary aspects also, ठीक है? So monetary and non monetary both wages we can say salaries. Okay now many companies give their night shift allowances, house rent allowances, travel allowances. Okay, so all together this is compensation management. Okay, all included in compensation management, right? So compensation refers to a wide range of ma'am, the last slide please. Yeah, so yes, you can read here. Compensation refers to a wide range of financial and non-financial rewards to employees for their services rendered to the organization. As I have said, just it includes base pay, like everything, non-monetary and monetary, both the aspects are included here. Okay, next slide, ma'am. Yes, so we have discussed objectives, right? So can anyone quickly tell me what are the objectives of like why a company should follow a compensation management or have a compensation management? What is the need for it? Or what are the
Ma'am, to
needs for it?
attract the more people.
See, yes, Vavna ma'am, suppose you are working under me, right? You are working hard,
Okay,
you are
ma'am.
paying almost, like you are giving almost 9 hour, 8 hour in a day. Okay. So in return, definitely you will like what if you are not like we are not giving you anything in return, would you work with us? No, right? So it's very important. Salary is very important because it definitely it is the main thing that most of the employees or most of the person, most of the people, they work for salary only, right? So the it's very important that you give a justified salary to your employee. So the capable employees are attracted towards the organization, right? It would motivate their like motivate them, and eventually they would give their 100%. It will increase their productivity. Okay, like a better performance, and the employees do not leave the employer frequently because if you are, you see, one aspect is definitely how good relation you are sharing with your manager, right? That is one aspect. That is the main, one aspect for leaving the organization or staying the organization. And the another one is salary or wages. Okay, so it's clear.
यस मैम।
यस मैम।
Okay, so can we start with today's topic?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So components of compensation, as I have just told, monetary, non-monetary, right? So monetary, those are related to money. Okay, there are two types, direct and indirect. Or non-monetary, like which is not related to money, right? It's clear, it's easy, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Next slide, ma'am. So first we'll start with direct compensation under monetary. So first one, we would look into base pay, then bonus, long-term incentives, and then perks or perquisites. Okay. So base pay, any idea about this base pay? Have you heard of this word? Anyone? Am I audible?
No, ma'am, I have no idea about it.
Okay, no problem. Others? Have you heard of this word, base pay? Okay, I'm
No, ma'am.
assuming. Okay, good. No problem. So base pay is the basic salary paid by organization to an employee. Okay, or initial salary paid to an employee, which is not like which are not including any benefits or bonuses or raises. Okay, excluding all these things, base pay is calculated. Okay, so an employee's base pay can be expressed as an hourly basis, weekly basis, monthly, or annual salary. So, as we know that, the most of the IT companies, okay, they do this hourly basis because 8 to 9 hour work, okay. And some of the companies, they calculate their base pay as weekly basis, okay. Some monthly, some follow the annual salary also. So basically, it depends on the company to company how the like compensation has been managed by that in that company. Okay, it differs from organization to organization. Clear? It's clear.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so it's the minimum salary paid to an paid to an employee by the organization. Okay, now bonus pay. Bonus pay, I think you have heard of this word, right? Bonus or bonus pay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay,
Yes,
who
ma'am.
said yes? I'm not. Okay, so any idea what is this, what bonus pay is?
Ma'am, it is a kind of additional salary payment.
Okay.
Yes, it's kind of additional salary given employee according to the work like that.
Yes, it depends on the performance, right? Bonus. So basically, additional pay, absolutely, this is a keyword. It's not included in base pay. So it's additional pay given to an employee on top of their regular earnings or on top of their basic pay or base pay, we can say that. Okay, so it is used by many organizations as a thank you to employees or a team that achieves a significant goal. So what does this mean? Suppose you have achieved something, some goal, okay, or you have given a tremendous good work to your organization. You have made something which is impossible to possible, okay. May suppose you have contributed a lot to gain a profit to your organization, particularly in this year. So definitely you will be rewarded for that, and that is called bonus. Clear?
Ma'am.
Okay. So basically, why this base pay happens in organization to organization? It helps each and employee, like each and every employee, to be motivated, right? If you are working hard, if you are giving a good effort to your organization to achieve your organization's goal, so definitely when you already achieve that, right, you should, like, you will expect some praises, like, okay ma'am, you have done great, yes ma'am, we are looking more from you, like these things. So in organization, it basically, the bonus is like that only. It will help that employee morale, motivation and productivity to improve. Okay, clear? Bonus pay, any doubts in this?
Ma'am, clear.
Okay, so next. Yes, Nehal ma'am. Next slide. Yeah, so long-term incentive. So basically, long-term incentive, now suppose you have a specific goal, okay, like when while managing performance management and all, you have set some goals which is long-term, not achievable in few months, okay. So see, a long-term incentive plan is a company policy that rewards employee for reaching specific goal that lead to increased stakeholder value, sorry, shareholder value. So it's basically, suppose you have some long-term goal which is aligned with your goal and organizational goal, so you have achieved that, right? Or you wanted, you are willing to achieve that. So after that, what will happen? Like, you should expect something more, right? You will work hard for that, for to achieve that goal. So but in return, you will get long-term incentive. So it is attached to that particular specific goal. Clear? It's clear?
Ma'am, would you please repeat one second?
Yeah, sure. So yes, what have you understand in long-term incentive? What is your basic understanding in this?
Actually, it is payment given to the employee according to performance or any goals like that.
Okay. Yes. So basically, see, the long-term incentives basically is specifically designed for executive employees. Okay, it's written here. See, usually an executive must fulfill various conditions or requirements, right? So when they have some long-term plan, okay, long-term plan, like after achieving that plan, there should be some reward to given by that employee, right? Executive, right? So it is nothing but that only. Yes. So suppose you have, like, executives know, right, which factors to focus on to improve the business, when the company growth, you know, is up and like sometime is low. So how to plan to match the long-term incentive, like to long-term plan, right? So
yes,
it's
ma'am.
Basically, yes. So it's basically related to that only, that after achieving that long-term plan, you will be rewarded, and that is called long-term incentive. Okay, so basically,
okay,
when
ma'am,
the company sets this long-term incentive plan, they decide on a period or of time, like when the employees will receive full ownership of the asset or stocks or the requirement funds. Okay, so that will come as a result of long-term incentive. Okay?
Yes, ma'am. Understood, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah. Okay. So clear, na?
Clear, ma'am.
Okay. Others? Akanksha, ma'am. Divya, ma'am. Gautam Sali, ma'am. Bhavna, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Any query? Okay, good. Now the next is in direct compensation is perks or prerequisites. Okay. Am I audible or
what? Like, okay, ma'am. Hello, ma'am. Okay, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am, you're audible.
Yes, ma'am, you're audible. I think she's having some network issue. So we were seeing perks or prerequisites. So it is nothing but fringe benefits that are received over and above the salary as a result of their official position. Okay, so it is given to the employees as like the benefit. So this can be include like travel allowance, then refreshments during office hours, maybe telephonic connections or health club and other recreational facilities. So there are many facilities available for the employees. These are other than their base pay and the incentives. Yes, so this was about the perks and prerequisites. And any difficulty until this point? Understood all the things in direct compensation? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, I was facing okay. Some network issue, I believe, so I couldn't hear. Okay, so yeah, direct compensation okay. Under this base pay, bonus, long-term incentive, perks, everything is clear? Or any doubt in this?
Everything clear, ma'am.
Okay, good. Yes, Nehal, ma'am.
Yes. So, now we will see indirect compensation. So, it is basically any benefit to the employees that doesn't come in the form of cash. Okay. So, it refers to the benefits that is offered or provided to the employees because of his service provided by them to the organization. So instead of being paid directly to the employee, so indirect compensation is calculated as an extra component of base salary. So it is different from direct compensation, which is like non-cash. Okay, it is in the form of non-cash. Okay, so they include like leave policy or overtime policy, hospitalization, insurance, leaves like sick leaves, holiday leaves, then clothes in the form of uniforms or the company parties, then phones and laptops are provided. Like we have seen now, work from home is there and the company is providing the whole system to the employees, right? And then retirement programs are there. So basically insurance is nothing but the organization provide for like accidental insurance and life insurance for the company. So this gives the employees the emotional security and they will feel themselves valued in the organization. Okay, so the organization is giving value to them. They are giving the insurance to them. So the employee will feel motivated, right? And then leaves. So leaves are... the employees are provided with the leaves and the travel allowances to go for holiday with their families, right? So some organization arrange the tour for the employees as well, right? So the leave travel is or the leave policy, it is basically the right of employees also. They should take the leaves. There are specific number of leaves that are provided by the companies to the employees. Like usually there are, I think, 20 leaves for a year, I think. And there are specific sick leaves, which are, I think, 15. And if the ladies are pregnant, and then there will be maternity leaves provided to her also. Right. We are aware about these things. And then clothes for the factory workers or the blue collar employees. The uniform is also provided by the company. Okay, the clothes, the dressing of the employees. Then the company parties, the company, the organization arranged the lunch for the team members, for the groups. Then they arrange the parties, the 31st December parties, these are the parties. It is kind of compensation, right? They spend money on the employees. And then phones and laptop, as I said, it is given to the employee who are working from home. And then retirement programs. So it organization provide for like pension plans then other benefits for their employees with the benefits them after the retirement. So after the retirement also the employees will not feel like they are not part of the organization and all. So there are retirement programs that the organization plan for the employees as well, right? So these are about the indirect compensation. Okay, like any doubt in these points? Indirect compensation? Yes.
No.
Okay. So can you tell me like why there is these kind of like direct compensation and indirect compensation? Everything can be given in one roof, right? Only compensation. So why it is like divided? No, you can give the employees just salary and you can tell them whatever you want to do. You want to take the paid leaves insurance. It can be done, right? But it's not done in the organization because indirect compensation also lead to the employee motivation, right? So it will employee will feel the company is having expenses on them, like by providing them insurance, by providing them the free leaves, right? So that's why this divideation is done under monetary compensation. Okay, understood? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so the next is non-monetary benefits. So as we know that non-monetary benefits are like it is non-cash, right? Non-monetary, non-money. There is no money involved. It is like more to the motivational factor, right? To the employees. So non-monetary benefits are essential to attracting the productive workforce. So if you are providing many benefits to the employees, like giving them rewards or other like awards also, recognition. So they will feel like motivated and they will feel satisfied while working in the organization. So these benefits will give a psychological satisfaction to the employees even when the financial benefit is not available. These are not financial benefits, right? So recognition of merit through the certificate, the organization can provide a like merit certification to the employees. It is non-monetary, right? There is no money involved, but still it is one of the benefits so that the employee will feel satisfied while working in the organization, right? Are you getting what is non-monetary benefits? Yes?
Yes,
am I audible? So why everyone is not responding today? Any problem? Are you people facing network issue?
No, ma'am. Everything is clear, ma'am.
Okay, Bhavna ma'am, Gautam ma'am, Akanksha ma'am, clear? What is non-monetary benefits?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, like recognition of merit through certificate, it is one of the non-monetary benefits. Then next is offering challenging job responsibility. See, employees working his day-to-day like job and he's getting his base pay properly, his like monetary benefits getting properly. But non-monetary benefits is also important, like as we have seen, like offering challenging job responsibilities. So some employees feel motivated while they are challenged to do a specific job, you know. So that's one of the non-monetary benefit. Then the promoting growth prospects, you know, providing promotions to the employees, right? It is also non-monetary benefits. Then comfortable working conditions as well, right? So providing them with the proper workplace, workstation. Yesterday we have seen cubicles must be provided for the employee satisfaction, for employee relation, right? So there must be comfortable working condition. You can provide them with some parties, like, you know, as we have seen in the indirect compensation. So you can provide like comfortable working conditions. That may be through giving them like proper leaves, or you can give them proper, like cafeteria can be provided, you know, that the employee should feel comfortable in the organization. That also one of the non-monetary benefit. And then competent supervision. The supervision must be like good, it must be proper. They will feel, they should not feel like our boss is hitter, you know. So the supervision also should be like competent, and then job sharing and flexible timing. So so flexible time must be provided, as now people are working from home. So flexible time should be given to the employees so that they can work in their home properly. So these are some non-monetary benefits. Yes, understood. Clear with non-monetary benefits?
Yes, ma'am, understood.
Yes. Okay, so this was all about components, right? So components of compensation, we have seen monetary and non-monetary, and under monetary we have seen these direct compensation, base pay, bonus, long-term incentives and perks or perquisites, right? And then we have seen the indirect compensation. So in basically base pay, there are so many allowances, for example, dearness allowance, right? And then house rent allowance. Okay, base pay includes basic salary, house rent allowance, then conveyance allowance, leave travel allowance, then medical reimbursement, right? So these are some things that are involved in the base pay. So first is salary, that is amount received for the work, it is like fixed. And then next is house rent allowance. So house rent allowance is, yes, anyone know the term house rent allowance? The company provides house rent allowance. So it is nothing but the company gives a specific amount to the employee while providing him with the salary, the CTC. It is nothing but if he is living out of the city, the rent will they will take care of the rent of the employee's house. So that all included in the base pay. And there are some laws and regulations that are provided by the government, and these are Minimum Wages Act, which is enacted in 1948. Then another is Employees Provident Fund Act in 1947. Then another is Payment of Gratuity Act. The next is Payment of Wages Act, then Payment of Bonus Act, then Employee State Insurance Act, and Workmen's Compensation Act. So anyone from you, are you aware about these acts? Any act? Yes.
Ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Okay, have you heard the word Provident Fund, PF?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, so what is it? Like PF, kya hota hai? The salary, the particular amount from the salary saved in the account, right? Yes, Gautam ma'am, you are not audible. You can just type the message so we all can read it and understand what you are saying. Yes. Yes, the specific amount from your CTC is taken from that, and it is saved, and after your retirement it is given to you. Okay, so that is Provident Fund. And then again, the what is new word? Yes, gratuity. Yes, anyone aware about the gratuity? Gratuity amount is given. Have you heard about this word? Anyone?
Yes, ma'am. Word has been heard before. I'm not sure about what is gratuity. Like, I do not know the perfect definition about it.
Yes. So gratuity is nothing but like, it is similar to gratitude, right? The word is similar to gratitude, and gratitude is nothing but like saying thank you for the work, right?
Okay.
Basically, gratuity is nothing but the Yeah, so the gratuity is the amount that is given to the employee when he is leaving, like it is by the resignation or retirement. So a specific gratuity amount is given as in the form of like gratitude as he worked for our organization, right? Yes, it is payable to the employee. So that is nothing but gratuity. And yes, we have seen the bonus in the direct compensation. And then the State Insurance Act, when the employee is having some accident or any case or any specific amount is needed to the employee, then that comes under this act. And then workman's compensation, as yesterday's class, when I asked what is compensation, some of you said that compensation is nothing but something fault or something accidental has happened to the employees and company have to compensate that. So what are those conditions? What is it that we are going to see in these acts? So these acts are like some explanatory, so it will not be covered in today's lecture. So we will see it tomorrow. So any doubt until like in the components of compensation? Yes, everything is clear in components of compensation.
Yes, ma'am. Everything is clear.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Clear.
Okay, then we will meet tomorrow.